like the eyes before a kiss. It's beautiful language. In the garden he prays that this overflowing cup could pass away. And in this hour of need, if there ever such a thing, out of fear I fall asleep. Oh, the hour has come. The hour has come. In the garden he but a glimpse of the calming sea, and every angel up above cannot calm the sorrow when a father leaves his son.
The first station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus was falsely accused. The King of the universe humbly submitted to Pilate's human authority and verdict. Unjustly judged, he trusted in and was obedient to his Father. He chose to suffer in silence. Pilate asked, "What is truth?" But because he did not belong to the truth, he fearfully gave in to the clamoring crowd that cried, "Crucify him, crucify him." Despite the warning that came to Pilate from his wife's dream, he washed his hands of the whole affair and handed Jesus over to be crucified.
Jesus, sometimes I am Pilate, when I do not stand for what is right, but silently go along with the crowd, when I thoughtlessly condemn another by my hurtful tongue. Help me, Jesus, to put a guard on my tongue and use it only as an instrument of your healing love. O Lord, in your mercy, do not be quick to condemn me. Help me to tame the critical and judgmental spirit that overtakes me in moments of frustration and anger. I place my hope in you, my Savior. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
the second station, Jesus takes up his cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus was taunted and tortured, humiliated and scourged, mocked and crowned with piercing thorns. Bleeding profusely and in a weakened state, he took up the cross by himself. He humbly accepted it without complaint, out of love for you and for me. In the depth of his humiliation, he embraced his passion. He embraced the cross.
Jesus, you willingly and lovingly placed upon your shoulders the weight of my sins. Help me, Jesus, not only to accept, but to embrace the everyday crosses in my life. In my weakness, let me call upon your strength to sustain me in the losses, the failures, the difficulties, and the rejections I encounter in my life. Grant me the grace to accept your will for me without complaint. In you, Lord, I place my trust. Amen.
When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain I count.
Third station, Jesus falls the first time. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. In his human weakness, Jesus fell under the weight of the heavy cross. His already battered body was bruised anew as unyielding cobblestones tore and stung his knees, and the unruly soldiers mercilessly jabbed and prodded him to get up. But Jesus did not retaliate, verbally or physically. In the midst of the many indignities inflicted upon him, the suffering servant kept his dignity. He got up and continued on his way of love.
Jesus, I repent of the many times I fail in following you, when I give in to temptation and fall into sin. In your everlasting love, you are with me every step of the way as I carry my cross. You nourish and strengthen me to continue on my journey. Help me to keep my eyes fixed on you and on the eternal life you have promised me. I freely surrender my life to you. With you, it is possible for me to follow in your way of love. Amen.
Down the Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to clear the narrow street, but the crowd pressed in to see Stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head, and he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the way of suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. The blood that would cleanse the souls of all way to the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the way of suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary.
The fourth station, Jesus meets his Blessed Mother. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. What anguish Mary must have felt to see her son suffer so much, but she too accepted and endured, bearing in her heart the cross of her son. In shared pain, she courageously followed him. Mary's silent looks of love radiated strength into Jesus, and helped to soften the verbal blows aimed at him by the hateful mob. Supported by his mother's love and comforting presence, Jesus continued on his sorrowful journey. What love they shared, a love that surpassed grief, a selfless love that redeemed the world.
O Mary, woman of silence, you pondered the mysteries of God in your heart. Who can fathom the depths of your grief? But your pondering your life in God had prepared you for this moment. You never faltered from saying, "Be it done unto me according to thy word." Lord, help me to remain steadfast to God's will for me, no matter how many wounds are inflicted upon me, especially by members of my own family. Their sorrow is mine, their shame is mine, their troubles are all mine to bear. My heart, too, is pierced with sorrow. Help me to unite my suffering with yours as I place myself and my loved ones at the foot of your cross. Amen.
Grow.
The fifth station, Simon of Cyrene helps Jesus carry his cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Bruised and exhausted, Jesus struggled to carry the heavy crossbeam on his bare shoulders. The cruel soldiers offered no help, nor did the jeering crowd. Seeing Jesus falter at every step, the soldiers feared he would not make it all the way to Calvary. So they pulled Simon the Cyrene from the crowd out of the comfort of his indifference and compelled him by force to help Jesus carry his cross. Simon came to realize what a precious gift he had been given. Once resistant and hesitant, Simon was transformed into a true cross-bearer of Jesus.
Jesus, often I am an unwilling Simon, hesitant to offer help, resistant to leaving my comfort zone, indifferent to the needs of family, friends, or even strangers. I'm reluctant because of what I might have to sacrifice. Sometimes I'm fearful of accepting the cost of being your disciple, but I reflect with gratitude on the many times in which I have been on the receiving end of someone's compassion. A meal provided by a friend when I was ill, my spouse's generous help when I was in pain, personal notes of encouragement sent when I was down. O Lord, out of my love for you, help me always to be a willing Simon, a true cross-bearer on my way of love. Amen. The sixth station, Veronica wipes the face of Jesus. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Dried, caked blood and sweat mixed with dust and dirt to disfigure Jesus' face. Jesus, the Lamb of God, allowed himself to be helpless as he was led to his slaughter, all because of his great love for you and for me. Seeing Jesus' wretched condition, a woman named Veronica bravely stepped out from the crowd, subjecting herself to possible brutality by the soldiers or retaliation by the crowd. She took her veil and tenderly wiped the face of Jesus. Grateful for this compassionate and courageous act of love, Jesus left the imprint of his face on Veronica's veil, a true icon of himself. Jesus, I don't know if I could have been as courageous as Veronica. Even in situations that cannot begin to compare with what Veronica faced, fear and timidity hold me back, paralyzing me from acting on behalf of someone or speaking out against an issue. I am too often concerned about what others may think. O Lord, help me to show your face to others by my acts of mercy and compassion. Anything I do for them, I do for you. Amen.
There's light for
The seventh station, Jesus falls a second time. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. The way of love was hard and steep for Jesus. Once again he stumbled and fell on the uneven cobblestones. The stabbing pain from his bruised knees and hands knifed through his tortured body. Yet still, Jesus rose again and continued his journey. With Jesus' unwavering love for us, he pushed forward and obediently carried the terrible weight of our sins on his shoulders.
Jesus, although you fell again, you still didn't give up. When life's burdens threaten to crush me, I sometimes think I can't go on. I can't bear another setback or disappointment. Yet, with a grateful heart, I thank God for the precious gift of my faith, knowing that you, Jesus, are always at my side and that you will never give up on me. May I always remember that you are my strength and my salvation. Amen.
Jesus comforts the women of Jerusalem. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus' encounter with the women of Jerusalem was a powerful example of his great love and compassion for others. In the midst of his own suffering and need, his loving heart was full of pity for the sufferings these women, his people, would have to endure. Jesus told them to weep for themselves, and for their children rather than weep for him. What selfless love, what incomprehensible compassion.
Jesus, my compassionate Savior, your words ring true today. Mothers and fathers shed many tears for their children, children who turn from you and fall into the darkness of this world and commit sins, who give in to peer pressure and rebel against their parents' values, who forsake their faith for passing worldly pleasures. O love, who once died for us, how our ingratitude must offend you, but you, the eternal giver and forgiver, love us still. Amen.
Be still, my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, he faithful will remain. Be still, my soul, thy best, thy heavenly friend, through thorny ways leads to a joyful end. Be still, my soul, that God doth undertake to guide.
midnight station, Jesus falls a third time. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus' human strength failed him, and once again he stumbled and fell. Even Simon's help could not totally compensate for Jesus' extreme weakness. Utter exhaustion and searing pain exacted their toll. Jesus was in dire distress. How humiliating for the Son of God to lie in the dust at the feet of a jeering mob. Still, despite his human frailty and intense pain, Jesus again willed himself to get up and carry his cross. His love was stronger than his weakness.
Oh my Jesus, I am all too conscious of my own weakness and helplessness. I get impatient when things do not go the way I've planned. When others' words and actions humiliate me, it is hard to keep from retaliating in anger. Lord, my faults and failings are many. Without you, I am helpless and hopeless. I need you. Help me to rely upon your strength, to carry on, to do what you have called me to do. In all that I say and do, may I glorify you. Amen.
The 10th station, Jesus is stripped of his garments. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus loved with an infinite love. How else could he have allowed even his dignity to be taken away from him? What cruel humiliation he suffered when the soldiers roughly stripped him of his clothing and exposed his body, the body that had once been tenderly wrapped in swaddling clothes by his mother at his glorious birth. Stripped of all he possessed, he was himself possessed by his father's love. By love possessed, the Messiah King possessed all. Jesus let go of everything in order to let God do a mighty work in and through him.
Jesus, help me to relinquish the material possessions and people I try to hold on too tightly, as if they were mine and not yours, as if I were the one in control. May your will be done as I learn to strip myself of attachment to anything that hinders my spiritual growth and prevents my being generous to others. Strip me of selfishness and sin, Lord, so I can embrace you with open hands and a heart full of love. May I too be possessed by the Father's love. Amen.
Station 11, Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Willingly, Jesus submitted to his crucifixion, enduring the excruciating pain that jolted his body when his hands and feet were nailed to the cross. These were not common nails. They were more like the spikes used on railroads to secure rails to ties, roughly 6 inches long and 1/2 inch thick, and with sharply tapered ends. The soldiers mercilessly pounded these weapons into the flesh of Jesus. What indescribable agony Jesus patiently withstood for you and for me.
Jesus, the terror and anguish of your barbaric physical crucifixion causes me to shudder. Oh, my crucified love, it is the weight of sin that has pinned you to the cross. In your great love, you freely will to be a prisoner of love. O Jesus, when I gaze upon a crucifix, how can I ever doubt your great love for me? May the memory of your passion always be in my mind and in my heart, helping me to walk with confidence in the dignity and freedom you have won for me. Draw me ever closer into a deeper union with you. Amen.
Call out among
The 12th station, Jesus dies upon the cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Love died an awful death. Uttering a loud cry, Jesus breathed his last, and with arms outstretched, he extended God's infinite love to everyone, embracing even his enemies when he forgave them and the world from the cross. Jesus never pretended his crucifixion wouldn't take place. He had told his disciples of it beforehand, nor did he run from this reality. Rather, Jesus faced his trials directly, including his crucifixion. Jesus not only suffered physically from this cruel torture, he also suffered an interior crucifixion of doubt, anguish, and seeming abandonment by God. Jesus' final perseverance was put to the test. Love passed the test.
Oh my Jesus, your immense love compelled you to suffer all, to give your life for me. Your total self-sacrificing love forces me to ask myself, whom do I love? How do I love? Jesus, help me to be more self-giving, to be sensitive and attentive to others' needs, to do the loving thing, no matter what it costs me. Crucify my doubts and timidity, Lord. Embrace me in your outstretched arms and grant me the grace of final perseverance. Amen.
Then sings my soul, my
The 13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. The power that was manifested in the supernatural events which occurred after Jesus' death, the curtain of the sanctuary torn in two, the earthquake, the darkness, terrified onlookers. The mocking and jeering finally ceased. Even an army officer was moved to exclaim, "Truly, this man was God's son." Pilate had granted permission to Joseph of Arimathea to take down the body. As Mary cradled the lifeless body of her son, she looked on him with the tender, compassionate love of one who had totally shared in the sufferings of her beloved son. Throughout his passion, Jesus had been strong, even unto death.
My Jesus, life and truth itself, your precious blood shed on Calvary made it holy ground. Your pierced heart, the source of your divine love, teaches me the value of a sacrifice that comes from love. What sweet mystery that you died for me, for us, while we were yet in sin. Jesus, help me to be more devoted to your passion, the true school of love. With your grace, I will meditate your passion daily as I try to live your way of love. Jesus, help me to be more like you and to become what I contemplate. I place my life in your hands. Amen.
14th station, Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore thee, O Christ, and we praise thee, because by thy holy cross thou hast redeemed the world. Jesus was laid to rest in a borrowed tomb. His mother and a few faithful women had prepared his body for burial. Through Mary's sobs, she could hear the large stone clang behind her, sealing the tomb. Death is so final. Why did he who had received the homage of shepherds and kings at his birth suffer such a cruel and shameful death? Why did he, the giver of life, freely relinquish his own life? Were the disciples' hopes also laid to rest in that sealed tomb?
O Jesus, my love, I can imagine the abandonment your disciples must have felt when they saw your sealed tomb. There are times when I, too, feel alone and abandoned, when you seem absent from me. But I believe in faith that your compassionate love never leaves me alone. I know you are with me in the desert of my waiting. Jesus, help me to empty myself so that I can be an empty vessel, ready to receive the fullness of your life and love. Help me to reflect your love to all I meet as I live my life in you. May your way of love be my way of life. Amen.